Welcome. In this video, I will be solving probability word problems based on the binomial distribution. Here are the properties of the binomial distribution, which is a discrete probability distribution. And here is the problem we want to solve. There are 8 unrelated questions on a multiple choice test. Each question has 5 options, and we want the probabilities that, by guessing, a student can answer this number of questions correctly. We see that the problem satisfies the binomial distribution properties because there is a fixed number of trials n, which equals 8. Each trial has 2 possible outcomes, correct or incorrect. The probability of success is fixed. Since there are 5 options in each question, the probability of success will always be 1 over 5 or 0.2, since the student is guessing. The probability of failure will be 1 minus 0.2 or 0.8. And the trials are independent since the questions are unrelated. I will be showing how to solve the problem using both the binomial formula and the cumulative binomial distribution table. Note that NCX here represents combination, which you can find on most scientific calculators and can also be calculated using this formula. Now, N equals 8, P equals 0.2, and Q equals 0.8. For part A, answering exactly 3 questions correctly. By applying the formula, we see that the probability of exactly 3 successes is 0.1468. To use the cumulative binomial table, we need to isolate 3 by taking the cumulative probability up to 3 and removing cumulative up to 2, which is denoted as you see here. So we take 0.9437 and subtract 0.7969. And that gives the same 0.1468 we obtained using formula. For B, answering all questions incorrectly means answering 0 questions correctly. Therefore, x equals 0, and plugging that into the formula gives 0.1678. Using the cumulative binomial table, we see here that the probability that x is less than or equal to 0 is 0.1678. Note that the probability that x equals 0 is the same as the probability that x is less than or equal to 0, since there is no x value below 0. Now, for at least 1 question correctly, we need x greater than or equal to 1. So we can just find the probability for x equals 0, subtract it from 1, and that will give us the probability for x greater than or equal to 1. In essence, the probability of at least 1 is 1 minus the probability that x equals 0, which we obtained earlier. So P of at least 1 is 0.8322. Next, at most 2 questions correctly. At most 2 means x is less than or equal to 2. That is, x is 0, 1, or 2. Plugging those into the formula, we have a total of 0.7969. And using the cumulative binomial table, we see that the probability that x is less than or equal to 2 is 0.7969. Next, at least 2 but no more than 5 means we want 2 to 5 successes. Using the binomial formula, we see that those add up to 0.4955. The cumulative table is a better option in this case since we have 4 calculations using formula. Since we want 2 to 5, we can take the cumulative up to 5 and subtract cumulative up to 1 from it. And that gives us the same result as before. For more than 1 and less than 4 successes, the only x values captured here are 2 and 3, since the word AND here means that we must find the intersection for both conditions. We can write it as P of 1 less than x less than 4. And using formula, the sum of the 2 probabilities is 0.4404. Now, from the cumulative table, since we only want to capture 2 and 3, we can take the cumulative up to 3 and subtract cumulative up to 1 from it. Therefore, from the table, we take the 0.9437 and subtract the 0.5033 from it to obtain the 0.4404 we had before. For part G, we're considering the probability of more than 2 and less than 3 successes. Since this is a discrete probability distribution, there is a gap between 2 and 3, so there are no points more than 2 and less than 3. Therefore, the probability that x is between 2 and 3 is 0. For part H, we want less than 2 or more than 4 successes. The word or here means any value covered is included. Now, using formula, if we decide to calculate the probability for every point, we have to do that for 6 different points. But we can use the complement rule instead. We can calculate the probabilities for 2, 3, and 4, then subtract from 1. Using formula, the sum of these 3 is 0.4863, and subtracting from 1 gives the required answer. Also, using the cumulative binomial table, we can find the probability that x is between 2 and 4, inclusive, and subtract from 1. The probability that x is between 2 and 4 can be computed by taking the cumulative up to 4 and subtracting the cumulative up to 1 from it. And on subtracting that from 1, we have the same result we obtained using formula. Finally, we want the probability that x is less than 2 and more than 5. The word and requires both conditions to be satisfied at the same time. Since there is no value that is both less than 2 and greater than 5, the probability here is 0. And that concludes this video. I look forward to seeing your comments and questions. Thanks for watching.